The coronavirus is spread through respiratory droplets, for example, coughing and sneezing and spit, since it's connected to your lungs. A single cough can produce up to 3,000 droplets, between 1 and 5 micrometers, which is 30 times smaller than the size of a strand of hair. When someone with the coronavirus touches something from their mouth and then touches something else, the respiratory droplets spread, so that when someone else comes along and touches that, and then touches their face, which is an opening, which can lead to the inside of their body. For example, their eyes, nose, mouth, and ears. The coronavirus is so scary because you can get the coronavirus, but you won't show any symptoms or know that you have it for 2 weeks. So you can still give it to other people. And it also can hide in places that you would never expect. It stays on wood and paper, metal, glass, and plastic, along with stainless steel, for 2 to 3 days, and 24 hours on cardboard. On things like clothes, it depends on how porous it is, how many holes it has. So if it's something like cardboard, the germ goes inside of the holes of the micro holes on the cardboard, and when you touch it, you don't get the germ because it's in the cardboard, and soon it dies. And something like jeans will probably protect you more than a crochet shirt. You can't get the coronavirus through your skin though. So it's really a matter of not touching your face and making sure you wash your hands before you eat. That's why people say to sneeze into your armpit, because it's sealed and it's farthest from people's faces. Also, you don't want to sneeze into your hand because you can touch other things and spread the germ everywhere. Now that we know how it's spread, who should we really be worried about? We should really pay attention to older people, people with respiratory problems, or ones that are already sick. The youngest coronavirus case reported is 7 years old, but kids younger than that have probably gotten it. And people think that there's a lot more cases than there are recorded because since there is 2 weeks for your body to take out the virus, you may have gotten it and not even realized it. But remember, even if you aren't showing any symptoms, you're still contagious, which is why social distancing and staying in your house is so important. People who are young with strong immune systems and are not sick, it'll probably just feel like a cold. People who are young, have strong immune systems, and don't have any diseases or are not sick will probably not be affected too hard. It will most likely just be a mild cold to you. The number one thing is to wash your hands for 20 seconds. You'd be surprised on how many germs are left after 5 and 10 seconds. It's also important to clean surfaces frequently. As I said, it can stay on surfaces for days and you don't know when it's there. So cleaning your surfaces frequently reduces that chance of you catching the virus. Wearing gloves and masks do help, but masks are not flawless. N95 masks are reusable and probably the most helpful and accessible for this time. But most people are using surgical masks, which don't filter air that well and are pretty porous. So tiny particles in the air can go straight through the masks. It also exposes your eyes. So you'd have to wear an N95 mask and goggles to really get the best coverage that is accessible to you. This is also helpful because the virus can stay in the air for hours. And lastly, staying home. If you're not going out to give the virus, no one's coming in to give you the virus, and you're not around asymptomatic people, the chances of anybody getting the virus are very low. This is a time of crisis where a lot of people are afraid, and it's important to stay calm and be safe.